More and more children are out of school, but parents don't want math learning to stop. They're turning to Mathnasium at home. Real-time math instruction tailored to your child's exact educational needs. It's the same face-to-face live instruction used in our centers for over 15 years, now on a computer. Your child can keep their math skills sharp, catch up, or soar ahead, from home or anywhere with an internet connection. To learn if Mathnasium at home is right for your child, visit mathnasium.com/at home. Mathnasium at home, changing lives through math.
Good day and welcome to the Mathnasium Schoolhouse. My name is Larry. Today we're going to begin exploring one of the most useful math concepts in real life. That's the concept of percent. Percent show up all over the place in the real world. Stop and think about it. At school, when you take tests, you might get a 70 or a 90 or 100%, so percents are part of that part of your life. Discounts at the mall, you may see signs that say 50% off, 33% off, 25% off. And when you go to pay for something, you have to deal with the percentages in sales taxes. Weather reports, 70% chance of rain, 20% chance of rain. Sports statistics, it seems that everywhere we turn in the real world, percents are definitely there. To help us understand and master percents, let's take a look at what the word percent actually means. So let me get the whiteboard here. So the word per, I'm gonna split it up here, cent. And what we're gonna do is take a look at what these two components of the word percent mean. So let's first look at per. So what does per mean? Well, let's see, if I earn $10 per hour, I earn $10 for each hour that I work. Or if you're driving in a car and you're driving 60 miles per hour, that means you drive 60 miles for each hour that you drive. So the word per embodies the notion of for each. Okay, and what about cent? Well, let's think about some of the cents in our world. How many cents are there in a dollar? 100. How many years in a century? Again, 100. How many centimeters in a meter? Hey, every time you see that word cent, it means the number 100. Rather like when you see the word try, it always means 3. And when you see the word quad, it always means 4. So now that we know what percent means, where to go? Let's use that knowledge to help us do some problems. So the first problem I'd like to do, let's do 5% of 300. Now we just said that percent means for each hundred, so the first thing we need to do is determine how many hundreds we have. And when we look at 300, we can see pretty clearly that there are 300s in 300. So percent means for each hundred, so we're going to count 5 for the first hundred, 5 for the second hundred, and 5 for the third hundred, making a grand total of 15. So 5% of 300 is 15. That's like if you had, oh, let's say you saved up $300 from birthdays and Christmas, and you wanted to put it in the bank. And the bank said, we'll pay you 5% interest for 1 year. Well, how much would they actually pay you? Well, they pay, as we just did, they pay you $5 for the first hundred, 5 for the second, and 5 for the third. So at the end of the year, you would have $15 in interest that you'd earned at 5%. Okay, to make this clear, let's try another question here. Let's go with 6% of 200. Okay, again, percent always means for each hundred. So how many hundreds do we have? In this case, we have 2. So it's going to be 6 for each of those hundreds. So it's going to be 6 twice. And of course, 6 and 6 makes 12. So 6% of 200 is 12. I'd like for you to try a couple of problems now. Okay, let's go with 9%. Oops, let me make that a little neater here, folks. 9% of 400 and 11% of 700. So I'd like you to put on your thinking caps and take a look at these problems, and please put your answers in the chat box. Of 700. Oops. Thank you. Okay, let's see for the first one here. If you followed the reasoning before, 9% of 400, we have 400s, so we're going to need 4 9s. And I'm not going to write that out. 4 9s is 4 times 9 is 36. So 9% of 400 is 36. How about 11% of 700? Well, both numbers got bigger here, but the process doesn't change at all. So what we need is to account for 11 7 times. So again, rather than write that out, 11 times 7, we are pretty sure we all know is 77. So looking at the chat box, it looks like, Joe, you got the excellent, good comment there. Okay, I see a lot of right answers there. In fact, I don't see any wrong answers. So it looks like things are moving along here. Okay, now we're going to take a little turn in this. And let's take a look at 8% of 50. Now, keeping in mind that percent means for each 100, in this problem we look at it and say, wait a minute, we don't have a whole 100 here, we only have 50. Well, let's stop and think for a second, what part of 100 is 50? And on a moment's reflection, 50 is half of 100. So if we get 8 for a whole 100, how much are we going to get for the 50? Again, please put your answers in the chat box. Ah, real good. It looks like everybody's caught on here. If we only have half 100, we only get half of the percent numbers, so half of 8 is 4, and we can put that one in the bank. Okay, let's do this one more time. How about 20% of 50? Okay, well, 50 is still half of 100, so we're not going to get all of 20, we're only going to get half of it, and half of 20, of course, is 10, so 20% of 50 is 10. Okay. I can see from all the right answers in the chat box that you guys are really following along here, but just to make sure that you've really got it, let's do a couple of more problems. Let's do 6% of 50, that one for you, and what else? Let's do 12% of 50. Okay. So again, I'm going to give you just a moment to think about this, and I will be right back. Okay, let's take a look now. Whoops, wrong board. There we go. So 6% of 50. Rather than me giving the answer, here comes a whole bunch of really good answers here. And several people saying the reasoning here as well. Again, we have half 100. We don't get all of 6, we only get half of it. So at 6% of 50 is 3. Pretty straightforward concept, isn't it? Once you understand the basic idea that percent means for each 100. Because indeed, that's what the word tells us. Percent means for each 100. Okay, and with that thought in mind, the next one goes pretty quick. Half 100. We get half of 12, and we get 6. Now things are going to get just a little more complicated in the sense that we're going to take the last two skills and put them together in a single problem. So this time we're going to start off with 4% of 150. Okay, well, let's see. 4%, we need to know how many hundreds we have. In this case, we have one whole hundred. And we have one half hundred. So we're going to get one whole 4 and one half 4 and put it together. 4% of 150 is 6. And to do it again, let's do 20% of 250. And before I put anything down here, let's see if some of you can come up with the answer to this and pop it in the chat box there. Okay, things are looking good. Wow, a lot of you are answering today. This is really good. So, for those of you who didn't quite catch on here, let's work this out. So what do we have this time? Well, in 250, we have two whole hundreds and one half hundred. So we need two whole 20s and half of 20. So 20% of 250 is 50. So now that we have this idea that percent means for each hundred, We can solve a wide range of problems. In fact, we're going to take on one more, but I want to give you a little bit of practice on this because not all of you quite caught on there. So let's go back and double check this. Let's do 10% of 350 and 12% again of 250. Okay, again, take a moment and think about these. Make sure your multiplication is correct. So what do we have here? So for 10% of, let me take this out of here to give myself a little bit more room to write. 10% of 350, it's gonna be, we have three whole hundreds, so we get three whole tens. And half a hundred, so we get half a 10. So 10% of 350, 10, 20, 30, 5. And we're in business. That last question was 12% of 250. And I think by now you're starting to really get the idea of this. I'm starting to see really good answers in the box. So 12% of, well, two whole hundreds and a half a hundred. So two whole 12s is 24. Half of 12 is 6. And put 24 and 6 together, we get 30. And while we're doing this, something really important is happening. And that is I'm pushing on you to sharpen your mental math skills. Because these problems, the numbers here, are pretty friendly numbers. As we do more advanced work in future videos, it's going to get a bit more complicated. But for the moment, being able to handle problems like this mentally is a very important skill to develop over time. Okay, one more level of this finding half of part. So far, the numbers we've been dealing with have been even numbers. Now I'm going to do a little bit of a curveball here. Let's do 5% of 150. Well, starting off, this is very similar to what we've done before. We got one whole hundred and one half hundred. So we get one whole five, and half of five. So how much is half of five? Well, for some students, this turns out to be a question they have to ponder quite a bit because it's not quite yet in their life experience. So let's come up with a really basic strategy for dealing with this. If I want to find half of a number, I need to find out what number plus itself, that is, what number doubled makes the number I'm looking for. So if I say, oh, 2 and 2, that's 4. 2 plus 2 is 4, but that's too small. So let's go up to the next whole number, 3 plus 3, which is 6, but that's too big. So we need a number between 2 and 3, because the number we're looking for here, we need some number plus itself to make the number we're looking for. So probably the most convenient number between 2 and 3 is 2.5. And let's see if that'll do the job for us here. Well, let's see, 2 and 2 is 4. A half and a half make a whole, which we refer to as 1, and 4 plus 1 is 5, so yep, 2.5 plus 2.5 is indeed 5. So half of 5 is 2.5. So we need a 1.5 for the whole 100, half of 5, 2.5 for the 50, and putting those together, 5 plus 2 is 7, plus the half is 7.5. So 5% of 150 is 7.5. Boy, that introduced quite a bit of new work down here, having to deal with doing the demonstration of half of odd numbers. And this is such an important skill. Let's try this again. Wish I had room to leave all of this, but okay, this time let's go with 9% of 250. Okay, again, the hundreds part is absolutely straightforward here. We have 200, so we need 2 9s. And for the 50, we need half of 9. Well, let's see, 4 and 4 is 8, 5 and 5 is 10, so it's going to be between 4 and 5. And as we discovered in the last one, when we find half of odd numbers, there's always going to be a half in the answer. So it's between 4 and 5. In fact, it's going to be at the halfway point, 4.5 for the 50. So we put these together, 9 and 9 is 18, plus 4 is 22. Plus the half makes a grand total of 22.5. As as I said, this is just a bit more complicated, and so I'd like for you definitely to practice a couple of problems. So, but let's go back over the logic here just to make sure that we're clear on what we're doing. As always, we're looking to see how many hundreds do we have. And when we have something other than pure hundreds here, we need to decide what to do with that leftover part there. So right now we're dealing with halves, and in some of our in future work, we'll be dealing with all kinds of numbers in those positions. Okay, so let me give you a little bit of practice on this now. How about 7% of 250 and 11% of 450? Okay, for some of you, this is going to take a little bit longer to work out, so I'm going to give you a little bit of time here, and I will be right back. Okay, the answers are starting to come in the chat box, and it looks like you guys are really catching on to how this goes with the rhythm of finding percent using the for each hundred method. So just to demonstrate here, to make sure that everybody is clear. So we want 7% of 250. So we're going to need to find how many whole hundreds, which is 2. So we get 2 whole sevens, and half a hundred. So we get half a 7, which is between 3 and 4. So it's going to be 3.5. And 7, 7, 14, 17 and a half for the first one. And 11% of 350, same routine, 300, so we get 3 11s. And half of 11, we're between 4 and 5 this time, so it's going to be, between 5 and 6, my bad. So it's going to be 5.5. So we have 11 3 times, which is 33, plus 5 is 38, so it's 38.5. Now, I'm guessing that most of you, when you started watching this video today, if I had asked you what is 11% of 350, you might not have been able to answer the question. But after this relatively short presentation and this one very key idea that percent revolves around the notion of hundreds, look at what you've been able to accomplish today. I'd like to do, before we wrap up, I'd like to do a couple of very practical problems. I mentioned that problem about bank interest at the beginning of the video. Let's say you went to the store and wanted to buy an iPod that costs $300, and the tax in your area is 9%. So the question is, how much is it going to cost you to get out of the store? That is, how much is it going to cost you for the iPod plus the tax? Well, the tax is certainly not 9, because percent means for each 100, and in this case we have 300, so we're going to in fact need 3 9s. So we have 9 plus 9 plus 9. Which is 27, so it's going to cost you $300 for the iPod. They're going to charge you $18 tax, so you're going to wind up paying $318. As that old expression goes, don't forget the sales tax. Another way that this shows up in the real world, let's say we're in a classroom and there are 50 kids. And 30% of the kids are boys. Question, how many girls are there in the class? Well, we can look at this actually from two perspectives. First of all, using the information that we're given, we can find 30% of 50. And that will tell us the number of boys in the class. So, hey, what is 30% of 50? Let me check the chat box here. Half of 100, half of 30. Ah, you're right. That is 15. So there are 15 boys in the class. Now, is that the answer to the question that I asked? Well, actually, no, because the question I asked was, how many girls are there in the class? So as so often happens when we're doing problem solving, after we've done a computation, the answer we get is not the final answer. It helps us to get the final answer, but it's not itself the final answer, because the original problem said there were 50 kids. We've discovered that there are 15 boys in the class. So to find the number of girls, we're going to have to take 50 minus 15, which I'm not going to do algorithmically. We're going to use some number sense here. How much is 50 minus 15? Well, 15 is 10 and 5, so let's take away 10 and then take away 5. So 50 take away 10, of course, is 40. 40 take away 5 is 35. So this class has 15 boys and 35 girls. So what do we learn today? Well, let's see. First of all, we've learned that percents are all over the place in the real world. Really important, because the more you're aware of that, the more you'll find yourself thinking in terms of percents. So how do we go about finding a percent of the, in the case that we've been dealing with here today? Well, what we have to do is figure out how many hundreds we have, and in some cases, how many parts of a hundred we have, and put those answers together, and boom, we're able to answer the questions. And as I said in the beginning, percents just show up all over the place. So the stronger you are with them as you move through school, the better off you're going to be. So stay tuned here to the Mathnasium Schoolhouse, because we will be presenting many videos that deal with the topic of percent. Also down in the comments, you can download a very short package of material to review and reinforce what's been presented here today. And thank you all for coming, and we'll see you next time at the Mathnasium Schoolhouse.
It's afternoons that seem to be the most hectic for us, so it was much more convenient when we found Mathnasium at home.
All right, so how do we do half of five? I think one of the best things about at home is that it really feels like you're almost at home with the student in their house teaching them.
I'm in my comfort zone.
You can just ask for help and the instructor will come right to you.
With Mathnasium at home, I know that they're getting the help that they need.
Awesome, great job.
Mathnasium, changing lives through math.